What's going on, everyone? This is DK Dynamite, and today we're going to be focusing on a massive news roundup regarding Call of Duty Black Ops 3. So, as you guys all know, I was focusing on Arkham Knight for the past 2 weeks while I covered some of the DLC. So, let's jump right back to Black Ops 3. I'm going to be focusing on all of the latest information here in this video, and the information goes all the way back to October 9th. So, let's get started right now. And I'm also going to be going in detail regarding Black Ops 3 Fridays as well. That's a lot of important information to be shared. So, starting off with, The Walking Dead Season 6 is sponsored by Black Ops 3. And based on that announcement, I've made the theory that possibly, just possibly, we might see a Walking Dead DLC for Black Ops 3 Zombies. That is my prediction. That probably won't happen, but I think that's just a good theory to talk about. You know, it would be pretty cool to see a standalone DLC zombie map that focuses on the Walking Dead universe with familiar characters like Rick Grimes, Carl, and so many other great characters as well. That would be pretty cool. So let me know down below what you think about that. But moving on with the information, we also got the announcement that there will be a DX Racer official Black Ops 3 gaming chair. So you guys all know DX Racer. They make some crazy, crazy, insane gaming chairs for all the big players out there. And I think this Black Ops 3 edition looks extremely nice, and I'll even consider getting one. I think it looks wonderful, and it does go very well with the PlayStation 4 Black Ops 3 Limited Edition if you guys end up purchasing that as well. But aside from that, we also got a couple of trailers focusing on the campaign and zombies. I'll be talking about that in a little bit. But also, we did get the announcement of the term exosuit within the latest Black Ops 3 campaign trailer. And a lot of people out there were a little skeptical on exactly what that meant. So I'm just going to quickly say, the movement we have in Black Ops 3 will not be anywhere similar to the movement we had in Advanced Warfare. A lot of people are afraid that we're going to end up seeing an exosuit type of mechanic in the campaign for Black Ops 3. But what I think is the movement in the campaign will pretty much be extremely similar to the movement we have in multiplayer, just with a couple of extra futuristic features that obviously would be too overpowered to include in multiplayer. So some of those features may be exclusive to the campaign, but we're not going to be seeing advanced rooftops in the campaign for Black Ops 3. I can guarantee that. And I think Treyarch obviously knows that there are people out there who like Advanced Warfare, and there's people out there who just want to stick with traditional movement or just stick with the futuristic movement we already have in Black Ops 3. So another crazy announcement was regarding the highly anticipated 9th specialist within Black Ops 3 multiplayer. And it was announced to be the Firebreak, which is a specialist featuring a weapon ability known as the Purifier, which is a flamethrower weapon, and the power ability is Heatwave. So a lot of people actually found the 9th specialist within some hidden PC files. So we were all expecting a flamethrower. We were all expecting Treyarch to come out and announce this highly anticipated specialist. And luckily, they ended up revealing it. It was extremely exciting. And a lot of us fans out there have been requesting some type of flamethrower mechanic in a Call of Duty. And no one's really done it yet. We, of course, had the flamethrower in World at War, and I believe another Call of Duty as well. Let me know down below in the comment section which Call of Duty specifically had a flamethrower. I'm going to say it's World at War, but correct me if I'm wrong. So yes, we were all expecting Treyarch to end Black Ops as a whole with a bang and give us something that we've all been requesting for a long time. So the description for this specialist says, a flamethrower that projects a steady stream of heat, incinerating anyone or anything unfortunate enough to be engulfed by it. And the ability is the heat wave. Rapid cycling heat sinks dump a stored thermal charge which stuns enemies near the user. So that's going to be pretty insane, but I'm assuming that this specialist will be a little difficult to earn. I'm just going to assume that right now based on how powerful it is, but we'll have to wait and see when the game comes out how powerful this specialist is and exactly how many kills you need to actually earn it. So another thing was there was a new multiplayer map known as Redwood that was revealed during some released Black Ops 3 footage. We also had the confirmation by a Treyarch staff member that Theater Mode is returning in Black Ops 3. We already knew that, but he did say that it was bigger and better than Black Ops 2. So I've been saying this for the longest time. I think Theater Mode is very important for Call of Duty, but if it increases lag, that's when it's not worth it. But now that Black Ops 3 is solely made for the current gen consoles and PC, I know there is a last gen version, but the game itself was built from the ground up for the current gen platforms. Now that that's the case, Treyarch is able to enhance Theater Mode to the point where it doesn't cause lag and to the point where it's stable enough for us to legitimately use it. And I know there is a last gen version of Black Ops 3, but we already know that that version of the game will be heavily watered down. And it'll also pretty much have half the content that's really in the game. So Theater Mode's not going to be there, esports, and so many other things, which I've already talked about. So I think that's exciting news. People out there who don't have capturing software or some type of equipment to actually record gameplay can use Theater Mode to their advantage. And I also think even for the big content creators out there who do have equipment, I think Theater Mode is beneficial to go in and record certain pieces of footage from different points of views. I just think that that's very beneficial for the big content creators who like making montages, sniping clips, so on and so forth. So that's exciting information. But other than that, we also got some information regarding ability to add bots in multiplayer offline. That's also pretty important. We also got the announcement that Black Ops 3 will feature 4-player split screen offline and 2-player split screen online. So a lot of people were kind of skeptical over the fact that split screen is kind of dying in a way for a majority of the games that we all know. And a lot of people are concerned about that, and I could agree on certain levels that yes, it is disappointing for people out there who like to play with a friend or someone at their house, etc. So I think it's great that Treyarch is still supporting split-screen gameplay. I just think that's very important for a certain type of players out there. We also got the confirmation regarding the return of hardcore game mode. So for all of you competitive players out there who love hardcore, you're in luck with Black Ops 3, since David Von der Haar himself confirmed that there will be hardcore game modes at launch for Black Ops 3, and more modes will be added into the hardcore playlist as time goes on based on the community's feedback. So we also got the confirmation that based on the feedback from the beta, there's going to be a lot of big improvements to the PC version of Black Ops 3, which to me is not a big surprise at all. Treyarch has been on top of everything ever since the beta first released, and I've never had a problem with Treyarch. You know, Black Ops 2 obviously wasn't perfect, but Treyarch was always on top of listening to the community, fixing major bugs, listening to all of our little things that we want fixed, such as weapons, maps, game modes, etc. You know, Treyarch's always been on top of that, and I have no doubt in my mind that they're gonna just be insane and on top of their crazy explosive sequel to Black Ops 2 this year. So other than that, we also got a big statement regarding why the campaign was cut from the last gen version of Black Ops 3. And I've said this before, I think if they're gonna make a last gen version of Black Ops 3, which to me they shouldn't, but if they are, they should at least do it right and provide a good amount of content for those last gen players. And based on all the announcements we've gotten, the last-gen version of Black Ops 3 is so watered down to the point where it's literally almost a different game. So not only was the campaign cut from the last-gen version of the game, but esports, theater mode, big game modes, DLC. There's so many things missing from the last-gen version of Black Ops 3 that I literally have to question everyone out there who would spend $60 hard-earned dollars on that game. I understand if you're in a situation where you financially can't purchase a current gen platform or a PC. I understand that. But my suggestion would be save every dollar that you possibly can. Don't spend a dime on the last gen version of Black Ops 3. Because you're not going to get half the experience. Not even half. If you buy it for the PlayStation 3 or the Xbox 360. But that's just my opinion. You guys have yours. Let me know what you think in the comments. But we also got another trailer for the Shadows of Evil, highly anticipated Black Ops 3 zombie map, which I'll also leave down below in the description. I'll talk more about those trailers in a little bit. But Treyarch also made a very important statement, which I wanted to talk about as well, regarding how the entire campaign is unlocked from the start. You don't have to consecutively complete each mission to unlock the next. Every mission is unlocked from the start. And they talked about how that resembles Netflix's season release. So, for example, a show like Daredevil that's on Netflix. Once the season starts, all the episodes are released on Netflix. You don't have to wait a week for each episode to come on. Netflix has a season release of episodes, as you guys all know. So in a way, Treyarch is right. Giving us the entire campaign from the start with every mission available is similar to the Netflix season release system. So to me, if people are concerned about spoilers and certain features being revealed too soon, it's basically everyone's decision whether or not to go in and play the last mission first or vice versa. And I think, obviously, Treyarch did that for a reason. And they're going to have certain features, certain weapons, certain upgrades, certain characters that will be locked if you play the last mission first. That's what I'm assuming right now. But other than that, you know, I think that's fine. I don't have a problem with having all the missions unlocked from the start. And plus, it's co-op. There's an ability for co-op play. So, either way, it doesn't make sense for one person to have all the missions unlocked while someone else doesn't. That would be saying that person has to beat the whole game first before you can go in and play co-op. That doesn't make sense. It has to be even. It has to be balanced. So, that's how it goes. And I have no problem with that at all. The free Zombies theme for PS4 is currently available for all the Black Ops 3 beta players who experienced the explosive, badass beta that came out at the end of August for PlayStation and Xbox. So it's a really nice skin, or I should say theme, for the PS4. It looks great. Definitely go and download it if you haven't already. We also got the confirmation that Carl's Jr. and Hardee's Fast Food will be holding a promotion for Black Ops 3 this year. So I'm honestly not surprised that a bunch of places are sponsoring Black Ops 3. You know, not only The Walking Dead, Mountain Dew and Doritos, but even a fast food place. So I'm expecting lots of big promotions this year with Black Ops 3, since, as we all know, Black Ops 3 is a new era for Call of Duty, and there's a lot of big changes, a lot of big improvements. The console exclusivity has now moved to PlayStation. So many big changes to Call of Duty this year that I'm just not surprised all these places are sponsoring Black Ops 3. So we also got an announcement regarding reaching certain levels in Black Ops 2 or Ghost or Advanced Warfare, and how that'll reward you in Black Ops 3. So this is something I didn't expect, but based on your level progression in Black Ops 2, Ghost, and Advanced Warfare, you can earn certain personalization packs, certain themes, and calling cards for Black Ops 3 multiplayer. So I'll also leave a big link down below in the description. We also got the announcement that Black Ops 3 will have 11 game modes at launch for multiplayer. And those game modes are Team Deathmatch, Kill Confirmed, Domination, Demolition, Hardpoint, Capture the Flag, Uplink, Safeguard, and Search and Destroy. So those are some pretty basic game modes, but we all know Treyarch will end up adding in at least another couple game modes over the course of the year. You know, I'm expecting that, but who knows? We'll have to wait and see how that turns out. It was confirmed that Black Ops 3 on the last gen will run at 30 frames per second for the PS3 and the Xbox 360. So that, of course, wasn't surprising. We all know that Black Ops 3 runs at 60 frames per second on PS4 and Xbox One, and at 4K for the PC, which is also not surprising as well. We got the confirmation that Black Ops 3 has a file size of 17.8 gigabytes for the PlayStation 3, according to the PSN store. So we'll, of course, see more details regarding the storage space over the next couple days. I know a lot of people are concerned about that, since games these days are taking up lots of space, not including DLC or updates. So that's definitely a big concern for a lot of console players out there. Another update was that the first copy of Black Ops 3 was out in the wild ever since October 22nd. So expect tons of leaks. Expect tons of information that shouldn't actually be released until the game comes out. And my opinion on that is this. People are going to get the game early. People are going to get their hands on the full experience before everyone else does. That's just a fact, and that happens with lots of games. But what I would say is, don't blame the YouTubers for talking about certain information. Even though there's people out there on YouTube who don't believe in leaks, people out there who are big content creators who say, don't post leaks, don't share them with me, etc. That's fine. But when people out there bash the YouTubers specifically for talking about the information, that's wrong. Because the way I see it, the YouTubers are the messengers for the actual pieces of information. Unless we personally got the game early and shared everything on purpose, that's a different story. But for me, for example, to talk about a leaked zombie map or a leaked zombie gameplay, if I talk about that, I have every right to. But I do understand people will get disappointed or upset that I'm talking about information too early. But remember one thing, I didn't release the information, I didn't post it, I'm just talking about it. And even though people would say, oh, well, the more you talk about it, the more it'll get out, the more people will see. And that's just how it is. That's how this generation is with social media, with controversies, so on and so forth. That's just how it is. But that's my opinion on leaked content. You can't blame the messenger for talking about something. It's like blaming the news for talking about a little kid who got shot. We don't want to hear that news. We don't want to hear little kids being shot, innocent children being killed. We don't want to hear that. But that's the news. People are reporting it. You can blame the news channel all you want, but they didn't kill the kid. They're talking about it because it's news. You guys get what I mean? Just wanted to bring that up real quick. But Black Ops 3 will also be playable at the Paris Games Week, which takes place October 28th through November 1st. At the time of uploading this video, that probably already passed, but I still wanted to bring that up just in case. We got an official Black Ops 3 launch trailer featuring gameplay from the campaign, multiplayer, and zombies. Again, check that out down below in the description. If you pre-order Black Ops 3 at GameStop, EB Games, or the Game Store, you will get a Nuketown personalization pack, which looks pretty nice. And I'm actually happy that so far, most of the pre-order bonuses are pretty basic. Little camo packs and themes and calling cards. Nothing too big. Nothing too big to the point where people are going to be missing out on tons of content right away. You know, I think that's just that's a good announcement so far. We also got an announcement that Black Ops 3 on the PlayStation 4 will require approximately 43.6 gigabytes of space. So yes, that's a massive file. And my prediction is that by the end of the year, after all four map packs release, after all the guns, zombie maps, and multiplayer maps come out, the game itself will probably require around 100 gigabytes of space. That's just my prediction. I could be wrong. I may even be right. Who knows? But I just know Black Ops 3 is going to be massive. There's going to be tons of content added in throughout the year. So you guys better free up enough space at least to download the game. Or if you're getting the disc. But other than that, you're going to have to free up tons of space. A crap ton. Delete all the games you don't want. Delete all the unwanted DLC you have. Because we already know that Treyarch's going hard this year with zombies. They're going to have some massive ass maps. They're going to require lots of space, so we all saw this coming. There was also a pretty big list that was leaked regarding all the multiplayer maps, which will be available at launch. And as I said earlier, we should have been expecting this. If a game has gone out onto the wild, then somebody out there is experiencing the full game. They see all the content, and they know everything about the game. So we should be expecting leaks like this. But I'm not going to go over the list in this video. I'll leave it down below in the description if you want to check it out. But yeah, this is just a normal leak. It really is. Because the way this gaming generation is, somebody's always going to get the game at least a couple weeks early. And they're going to post leaks. But it's our choice whether to read those leaks or to look into them. That's just the reality. But we also got the announcement that Black Ops 3 DLC will include reimagined maps from World at War and the Black Ops series. So, for those of us out there who are looking forward to some reimagined maps, some classic maps to be brought back in Black Ops 3 from World at War and from the previous Black Ops games, we're in luck, since Treyarch confirmed over the course of the DLC season, we'll be seeing maps from both World at War and the Black Ops series. So, I would assume maybe around DLC 2 or DLC 3, maybe we'll see the return of a couple of World at War or Black Ops 1 multiplayer maps. And we'll probably see the return of a couple of Black Ops 2 maps as well. What we don't know is whether or not we'll see the return of a zombie map. I am assuming we'll probably see some type of Easter egg on the new maps that are coming out, hinting at the return of a new zombie map. You know, who knows? We'll have to wait and see. But I am assuming that, like Transit, where we got that Nocturne Toadin Easter egg, if you guys remember, back in the cornfields of Transit, we'll probably get an Easter egg like that. You know, on some of the new maps, we'll probably see references and sort of areas that were similar to previous zombie maps. We also got the confirmation that the Season Pass will include access to the Giant Zombies bonus map. So for those of us who are buying the game on current gen and PC, we're in luck if we're buying the Season Pass, because we will get access to the Dereis remake here in Black Ops 3. Unfortunately, we got the announcement, as we all expected, that the Season Pass won't be available for the last gen. So we already had the announcement that DLC offerings would be different for last gen, so it's not a surprise that the Season Pass won't be available. And the type of DLC offerings that will be available will be announced during the DLC season. So I'm assuming maybe multiplayer maps and zombie maps will be the only pieces of content to be released for DLC. I'm assuming guns won't be available, customization, micro DLC, all that stuff probably won't be included with the DLC offerings for last gen. But let me know what you think about that down below. I was expecting that. We all knew it was coming. So let's jump into some more information here. We also got a official unboxing posted by Call of Duty for the Black Ops 3 Limited Edition PS4 and the Juggernaut Edition. So I do have an announcement video coming up regarding the Juggernaut Edition. I'm very excited to share with you guys, so be on the lookout for that. We also got a highly anticipated announcement regarding the zombie storyline. So it was confirmed that the Giant Zombies bonus map will have new Easter eggs, it will have a new narrative system and more. I will leave more details down below. But it was also said that the original core Black Ops zombie story will continue with Black Ops 3 DLC. So we know that the Giant bonus map takes place right when Origins finished off. So we were then skeptical over whether or not Shadows of Evil will also play into that storyline. So what I'm thinking is that Shadows of Evil will be pretty much the Mob of the Dead for Black Ops 3. It'll be a standalone zombie map that may have Easter eggs and references to the core storyline, but it's kind of just a standalone map with its own storyline and own set of characters. And that's fine. That's also exciting, because Mob of the Dead was a beautiful map. Just beautiful. It was insane. And I'm glad that Treyarch did clear up a lot of our questions regarding the storyline. So, yes, the original core Black Ops Zombies storyline that ended with Black Ops 2 will, of course, continue in Black Ops 3 DLC. I'm hoping for a continuation from Moon and a continuation from Buried, aside from the continuation with the prequel story with Origins and the Giant. It was also confirmed that there will be a lot more Easter eggs in Shadows of Evil than any other previous zombie map. So we already know the big zombie YouTubers, all the big zombie players, they're going to be going hard with Shadows of Evil. They're going to be going for those big Easter egg tutorials, crazy little Easter eggs around the map. We're going to have to wait and see how that turns out, but that sounds insane. It was confirmed that Black Ops 3 on the PC will require 60 gigabytes of space. So that to me really isn't too surprising. You know, if the game is around 44 gigs on PS4, probably around the same for Xbox, you know, we were expecting, you know, something around that range in the 50s or the low 60s, stuff like that. So that's not surprising for a 4K next-gen Call of Duty. That sounds pretty reasonable for PC. Even though that's a lot, it's still pretty reasonable. But it was confirmed that there will be a new category of challenges in Black Ops 3 called Dark Ops. So David Von der Haar has updated his Twitter to be all black. That is a reference to the Dark Ops challenge system. You can tell it's going to be big. And David did say that these do not count towards your percentage completion for operations. And as he tweeted, but you don't know what they are until they are earned. I give the internet 5 minutes and you will have them all figured out, LOL. So yeah, this is going to be huge. Dark Ops will pretty much be certain challenges that you don't even know exist. You're just going to do something and you'll earn a medal for it, and you won't even know until you see the medal. So that's going to be more interesting once the game actually comes out, when we actually understand how the system works, what we have to do, and maybe some type of Easter eggs or hints regarding what exactly the challenge system is for Dark Ops. But there was also an announcement for a Black Ops 3 themed beer coming exclusively to Australia. So for those of you Australian gamers out there, you're going to be enjoying some Black Ops 3 themed beer. So that's pretty interesting. We did get an announcement regarding four upcoming multiplayer maps known as Metro, Breach, Exodus, and Havoc. So these maps were revealed during the Esports Paris Games Week live stream, which came out a couple days ago. So that confirmation was separate from the leak that came out regarding all the multiplayer map names. So this was officially confirmed by Treyarch. So that's not a leak. That was confirmed. But next up, ESL confirmed that they are going to be partnering with Activision for Call of Duty World League Pro Division this year. So for those of us who are familiar with what ESL is, we all know that that just means esports for Call of Duty is going to be even better and even bigger overall for the coming year. And we know that if this partnership is successful, we can expect ESL to also continue partnering with Call of Duty for the next couple years as well. So that's big information, you know, for all those MLG players out there who play competitively, who go to championships. That's going to be just an insane experience, a ton more fans, so on and so forth. But the beta season of Arena will start November 6th alongside the launch of the game. The stats are to be reset after the end of the beta season. So I think it's good that Treyarch is doing a beta season for the esports structure, just so people out there who aren't familiar with esports, or people out there who need to get used to esports again, have enough time to adjust to the settings, things that are banned, and overall just the rules of esports altogether. So that's beneficial, and that's good that they're doing a beta season, first of all, for the esports structure. Microsoft did say that they expect Black Ops 3 to be a really big title for Xbox, even without having the DLC deal for the first time in years. So I've talked about this before. I think Black Ops 3 is going to be a massive game as a whole. No matter what platform you buy it on, it's going to be massive. Obviously, the PlayStation 4 will have its own exclusive content, such as probably skins, themes, so on and so forth. And they, of course, will be getting DLC a month early, as well as updates. But I don't think that means that the game itself will be complete shit for the Xbox. I just think that means PlayStation players get a small benefit, which is being able to play maps early. But there are, of course, pros and cons to getting DLC early. One of those cons for Xbox would be having the fact that the zombie map that just came out has already been leaked and explored on YouTube. And there's already gameplay, there's already Easter egg steps, and those are just things that the Xbox will miss out on. But in a way, that's fair, since the PlayStation missed out on that opportunity for the past, what has it been, 7 Call of Duties, which Xbox had DLC exclusive for. That's just the reality. And I think it's an even harsher reality for the Treyarch Call of Duties, because with zombies, like I said, zombies is a big part of Call of Duty. And when a map first comes out, there's obviously going to be tons of videos on YouTube posted about the map, such as Easter eggs, music tutorials, you know, cutscenes, so many things that are posted on YouTube which the other platform can't experience. So unless you block yourself away from all that content being posted, the map is pretty much spoiled for you by the time it actually releases a month later on your platform. So that's just my opinion. But Black Ops 3's free run mode has 4 different courses on disc. So based on this announcement, we could assume that more courses will be added over the course of the year. But the 4 courses include Alpha, Sidewinder, Infected, and Blackout. In addition, players will be able to select difficulties that they wish to play on different maps. They could also compete with their friends during this free run game mode. Another big announcement was that Avenged Sevenfold actually wrote instrumental score for Black Ops 3. So let me be honest with you guys. I think Black Ops 1 had the best soundtrack system for zombies and multiplayer. That's just my opinion. And I'm glad that we're seeing some familiar faces talk about the music for Black Ops 3. I'm hoping Elena Segment comes in and writes some badass zombie music again. Because Black Ops 1 had crazy fire-ass music in the zombie maps. I'm just hoping that Black Ops 3 has the same experience. But yes, Avenged Sevenfold, damn, they're going to be killing it with some of the music they're going to be adding onto some of the, I would say, multiplayer maps and maybe even zombies. We'll have to wait and see. Monster Energy promotion for Black Ops 3 Zombies is currently live. So if you guys have codes from your Dorito bags or your Mountain Dew caps, be sure to redeem them. Preloading Black Ops 3 on the PS4 is currently available. So make sure that if you're going to be pre-ordering Black Ops 3 on the PS4 digitally, that you preload the game so that you're ready to play right when it releases. I would assume midnight on Thursday, but who knows? We'll have to wait and see. We also got a bunch of trailers focusing on the campaign and zombies. So in terms of zombies, we did get a prologue trailer for Shadows of Evil. And that trailer didn't spoil too much, but it did reveal a couple of exciting mechanics that we're going to be seeing in the game. I'll leave that down below in the description. But I think what was really exciting was the exclusive GameStop trailer that we got regarding the giant bonus map. So I just think the storyline for Black Ops Zombies has always been super complex, and it always left us on the edge of our seats waiting for the next map to come out to see what actually happened. And I think based on this one trailer, I can already tell that the storyline in Black Ops 3 is going to be insane. And since this is probably going to be the last Black Ops game in the Black Ops series, we could assume Treyarch will do their best to end the zombie storyline in the best possible fashion. And they're going to do so by releasing kick-ass zombie maps, kick-ass DLC, badass cutscenes, fire-ass music, so on and so forth. We also got a pretty exciting trailer showing off the new Nuketown bonus map, which will be featured in Black Ops 3. This map takes place in 2065 and is a futuristic simulation of the classic Nuketown we all know and love from Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2. So the map itself has, of course, been redesigned for the new chain, the movement system. Here's the official description. Set in 2065, this fan favorite map from Black Ops has returned in a big way. Nuketown has been redesigned from the ground up to highlight Treyarch's new momentum-based chain movement system, allowing players to battle in this adrenaline-charged multiplayer map. Players will experience a new take on this classic run-and-gun close-quarters map. Escape a harsh reality and enjoy this virtual neighborhood of the future. So, I know a lot of people are skeptical over whether or not this is just a business move to get more pre-orders, or whether or not if this is a well-designed remake of Nuketown. And in my opinion, I think it's both. Obviously, they have to do what they can to increase the sales of Black Ops 3. And by bringing back Nuketown, this obviously brings back a lot of classic Call of Duty players who maybe haven't even touched a Call of Duty game in years. And aside from that, I just think, based on the trailer and the gameplay we've seen, Treyarch has done a hell of a job with ensuring that the core Nuketown experience is still there, yet with the addition of certain areas which are compatible with the new chain movement system, which I also think is great. I love the new movement system. It's just, it's a fantastic balance between traditional movement and futuristic movement. And with Nuketown, it seems they're continuing that balance of movement to the point where you can still play the map traditionally, just with the addition of certain areas which you can access and use the movement with. The trailer is, of course, down below in the description if you want to check it out, aside from the other trailers that they also released regarding zombies and the campaign. But last but not least, let's talk about the Black Ops 3 Friday streams, which have been going on for the past couple weeks now. And even though this video has been insanely long, I still wanted to complete this news roundup by talking about what has actually been shared over the past couple Black Ops 3 Fridays. So a lot of this information is information that I already spoke about in this news update, but just to wrap things up and to officially confirm for you guys, Black Ops 3 Friday number 1 revealed the 9th Specialist, a new multiplayer map known as Redwood, talked about theater mode, bots, split screen, new gestures, and the fact that hardcore modes will be available in multiplayer. Black Ops 3 Fridays number 2 talked about a new game mode known as Free Run. Treyarch studio head Mark Lamia announced a new loyalty program and talked about 11 game modes being available at launch. Black Ops 3 Fridays number 3 revealed a new trailer for the Giant, unboxed the Juggernaut Edition, announced a new giveaway, talked about the Giant bonus map and how it features new narratives and new Easter eggs. They also talked about the core Black Ops zombie story, continuing with Black Ops 3 DLC. They talked about the Shadows of Evil map and how it features more Easter eggs than any other map ever released. And for Black Ops 3 Fridays number 4, we got the announcement of yet another new giveaway and got the trailer for the Nuketown bonus map, as well as some discussion about the Dark Ops challenge mode as well. But at the moment, at the time of making this commentary, that is all the currently released information for Black Ops 3 multiplayer, campaign, and zombies. Definitely let me know in the comment section what you guys think about all of this information. Thank you for sticking with me throughout this long news roundup. I just wanted to get back on track and talk about all the latest news, give my opinion on everything, and just talk about all the information as a whole. But be on the lookout for some Black Ops 3 beta gameplay, which I still want to upload as I prepare for the official release of Black Ops 3 this Friday, November 6th. I'm really looking forward to it. I'm super hyped up. All this information is just insane. And also, as I said earlier, in the description, I will leave links to multiple release trailers for the game, as well as some articles and lists of information, which I also talked about here today. But thanks for watching, everyone. This has been DK Dynamite. And be on the lookout for the latest Call of Duty information, gameplay, and coverage. As always, really hope you've enjoyed. And peace out, YouTube.